Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Gear Tower clock revisited. When I showed the original Gear Tower clock, people really liked the concept of this stack of gears, and I had several questions. One of the questions was, can you add a hand for the seconds? Another question is, can you motorize it? And another question is, can you make it higher? Well, I have done all three of things, and let's start with looking at the motorization. If we look at the back of this new version, what you see is a stepper motor and a little print and a USB power source. This set of stepper motor with the little print was made by my friend Rogier Wolf together with Peter Knoppers. And together they worked out how this should work and that it was calibrated such that every second on this clock is really a second. So let's also look at the second, the hand that gives the seconds. What you see is that now we have, instead of two dials, we have three dials. One, the yellow one for the hours, the orange one for the minutes, and the red one for the seconds. And when you put them all on top of each other, it's of course the hand with the seconds that you see running fastest. Looking at the gear mechanism, now we see not three layers of gears, but a fourth layer. And you need that fourth layer to have the hands for the seconds. So getting to the question, can we go a bit higher? Well, I've added some more gears. So let's just stack up, and here we go. And you see, it's easy to set this clock to a different time, and well, it just keeps ticking. Going even higher, here's another set of gears. And still the clock keeps ticking. Of course, it looks a bit unstable, but when I pick it up and move it around, you see that the whole contraption is actually quite stable. In a time-lapse video, you can of course see also how the minute hand and the hour hand turn as well. My question to you about this gearing contraption is, why doesn't it fall down? What keeps all the gears standing upright? Thank you for watching.